Good morning, class 3rd. My name is Hemlata, and today I am going to take your EVS class. Our today's topic is food and feeding habits of animals, which is taken from your textbook, chapter number 1st. In this video, we will cover all these following topics. First, food. Second, need of food. Third, herbivorous. Fourth, carnivorous. Fifth, omnivorous. Sixth, how do animal eat? And last one, food chain. So firstly, class 3rd, we will discuss about the term food. Food means whatever you eat, like mango, spinach, ghee, etc. Actually, we need food for our growth and health. On the other hand, food gives us energy to perform various kind of activities like playing, studying, etc. If you notice that when you are hungry, then there is no energy in your body to do anything. Thus, we can say that food gives us energy to perform various activities, and also it's useful for our growth. Now, here are some questions. First, why do we need food? We need food to get energy and stay healthy. Why do animals need food? Animals need food for energy and their growth. Name one fruit that a monkey likes to eat. Banana. Okay? Now, whenever you look around your surroundings, then you will find that every living organism need different kind of food. For example, cow needs plant and plant products, but lion eat flesh of other animals. In that case, if a tiger is hungry, so it cannot eat grass because it is not in its habit. On the basis of these food habits, we can classify all animals into three categories. First one is herbivorous. Animals who eat only plant and plant products are called herbivorous. Example, cow, goat, etc. They eat plants or plant products. That is why they also known as plant eating animals. Second category is carnivorous. Animals who eat only flesh of other animals are called carnivorous. For example, lion, tiger, etc. They also known as flesh eating animals because they depend for their foods on the flesh of other animals. Third one is omnivorous. Some animals eat flesh of other animals as well as plant and plant products. They are called omnivorous. For example, crow, dog, human beings, etc. There are some animals which placed into some other categories of animals are also there. First, pet animals. Second, domestic animals. Third, wild animals. Pet animals like dog, cat, etc. They give us company, and as you know, dog guard us. Second, domestic. Useful in many ways. Domestic animals useful in many ways, like they give us milk, and by selling out the milk, we get money. It means they are helpful in our earnings. Thirdly, wild animals, which are found in forest, like lion, tiger, etc. Now, here are some multiple choice questions. Firstly, plant-eating animals are called, as we talk about the herbivorous animals in the very beginning of chapter, we know that herbivorous are animals who eat only plant and plant animals, plant products as their food.
इट मीन्स हर्बीवोरस इज योर आंसर. सेकेंडली कार्निवोरस. कार्निवोरस आर द एनिमल्स दैट ईट ग्रास ब्रेड फ्लैश. कार्निवोरस आर टोटली डिपेंड ऑन द फ्लैश ऑफ अदर एनिमल्स फॉर देयर फूड. इट मीन्स योर आंसर विल बी फ्लैश. थर्ड डैश आर ओमनीवोरस. एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ ओमनीवोरस क्रो एंड ह्यूमन्स. दीज आर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ ओमनीवोरस. नाउ आर टॉपिक इज हाउ एनिमल्स ईट. वी स्टडीड अबाउट द फूड हैबिट्स ऑफ डिफरेंट एनिमल्स. एज पर देयर फीडिंग हैबिट्स देयर वेज ऑफ ईटिंग आर ऑल्सो डिफरेंट. देयर वेज ऑफ ईटिंग टोटली डिपेंड्स ऑन देयर फूड. देयर आर मैनी वेज ऑफ ईटिंग फूड. फर्स्ट वन इज नेवरस. एनिमल्स लाइक रैबिट हैव वेरी शार्प फ्रंट टीथ फॉर कटिंग. दिस मैथड ऑफ ईटिंग फूड इज कॉल्ड ग्रेमनिंग. और दीज टाइप्स ऑफ एनिमल्स आर नोन एज नेवर्स. सेकेंडली एनिमल्स हु स्वॉलन देयर फूड होल. इट मीन्स सम एनिमल्स लाइक फ्रॉग लिजर्ड एक्सेट्रा स्वेलो देयर फूड विदाउट च्यूइंग. दिस टाइप ऑफ एनिमल्स हैव अ लॉन्ग एंड स्टिकी टंग. देयर स्टिकी टंग हेल्प्स देम टू कैच देयर प्रे और देयर फूड. क्लास थर्ड डू यू नो एन इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट अबाउट द स्नेक. येस दे डोंट हैव एनी च्यूइंग टीथ इन देयर माउथ. इट मीन्स दे ऑल्सो स्वेलो देयर फूड होल. थर्ड वन इज एनिमल दैट टीयर एंड च्यू फ्लैश. दीज टाइप्स ऑफ एनिमल्स आर कार्निवोरस. इफ यू नोटिस दैट द फ्रंट टीथ ऑफ लायन टाइगर आर शार्प कर्व्ड एंड पॉइंटेड because they tear the food with the help of these teeth and their back teeth broad and flat which help them to chew the flesh. Fourth one animal that can eat and chew grass. These types of animals are herbivorous like cow, goat, buffalo, etc. Their front teeth are flat sharp and broad. They bite the leaves and grass with the help of them and by their strong grinding teeth they chew their food. These types of animals are called ruminant because firstly they swallow their food and later they bring it back to the mouth and start chewing it again. This process is called rumination. And those animals perform this activity are called ruminants. This half-chewed food is called cud. And animals, those perform rumination are called cud-chewing animal. Now, last one is animal that take in liquid food like mosquito, leeches, etc. They have a long and hollow tube that they use to suck blood. Butterfly, as you know, butterfly suck nectar from the flower. In the same kind of manner, mosquito and leeches suck blood as their food. Some animals like dog, cat, lap up milk and water by their tongue. This method of taking food is called lapping. Now, come to the MCQs, multiple choice questions. Firstly, rabbit and rats are called. Rabbits, as you know, rabbits and rats are eating their food by the process of nevering. It means they are nevers. Secondly, snake and frog swallow their food whole, partially or after tearing. As I said before, snake do not have any chewing teeth in their mouth. It means it swallow their food as whole. So, answer whole. Option first is the answer. Which animals take liquid food through lapping? Cat, mosquito or snake? As I said before, snake eat their food, swallow their food whole. Mosquito are blood sucking. So cat is the answer. Now our next topic is food chain. Food chain formed by the animals and plants. In our this lecture, we studied that every animal has different food habit, but if you noticed, animal depends on plants or other animals for their food, directly or indirectly. At this dependence form a food chain. Let it explain with an example. Suppose there is a green plant. It is eaten by the grasshopper as their food. Okay. Now, grasshopper eaten by frog. After that, frog eaten by snake. After that, snake eaten by eagle. So, it forms a chain. And this chain is called food chain. Okay. In this picture, grains are eaten by rat. Then snake eat the rat and then snake eaten by the eagle. It means it form a chain and this chain is food chain. Is this clear? So, our this chapter has completed. The regarding PDF of question answers of this chapter will be shipped shortly in your WhatsApp group. If you have any kind of query or doubt regarding this video, and you want to ask any question, then you can directly ping us on WhatsApp. Thank you. Have a nice day.